The Roundhouse concert includes a music theatre piece by the American Eric Salzman. Boulez and Salzman meet the producer, Bill Fitzwater, and the studio manager, John Rushby Smith, to discuss the staging of the work. The piece involves, in addition to singers and instrumentalists, special lighting and film projection.
The moments of the second part,
yes.
The ones that have been pre-recorded. This is an earlier version, which actually we could
play a little bit now.
Yes. One I already had prepared. I think the one we should use in the performance is the one that actually involves the people that we're doing.
Yes.
But this will
give us an idea
of the material that,
And how long it takes to record it.
Exactly. Sure.
Is this the sort of thing you want to prepare in the studio?
Yes. Right.
In other words, it's something like this you want us to produce in preparation for the Roundhouse.
That's it. One point I wanted to mention here that I actually wanted to ask you about. This was before the 2D rehearsal. That schedule is very... Your schedule is incredible. I can't...
The title Foxes and Hedgehogs comes from a fragment by the Greek poet Archilochus. The fox knows many things, but the hedgehog knows one big thing. Salzman is worried that culture today places so much value on amassing disconnected pieces of knowledge. In the Roundhouse after the concert, he was to explain what led him to write the piece.
One of the things that I was very struck by was that technology was changing the nature of musical communication very fast, and that this was not just a matter of having a lot of new techniques and toys to play around with, synthesizers and the like. In fact, we've reached a point where a tremendous percentage of our musical experiences come through loudspeakers. Now, this, of course, is just one aspect of a much larger impact of social and technological change. And it seemed to me necessary to deal with these problems and to deal with them in a very direct way. The fact that we're here in the Roundhouse and that this whole situation has been set up and this piece has been performed in that situation does, in fact, represent some kind of a change.
Okay?
Yes, that's it.
These are very similar sort of tongue clicks,
yes.
Sort of kisses or lip plosives, this kind of what symbol are you using? Well, actually, I use an L, actually. These are glottal sounds.
Catherine's the bed.
These will come through the front ones. Well, this is heard both ways, you see. This is pre-recorded and live, and one immediately follows the other. This is sort of image and the reality kind of situation.